In the last video about quadratic functions, we talked about functions that looked a little something like this. You take the basic x squared graph, you shift it right and left, and you shift it up and down. This form of a quadratic function very easily gives you the vertex of the function. It's just hk. And you can even multiply this function by some number, and that number will stretch and squish the function vertically, and it can even flip it over the x-axis. However, not every quadratic function comes to us in this form. A lot of times we have a function of the form ax squared plus bx plus c, for example. If a is 2, b is negative 5, and c is negative 3, our quadratic function might look something like that. And the main question I want to answer in this video is, how do we find properties of this function so that we can graph it? In other words, how do we find its x-intercept, its y-intercept, its vertex? In order to answer one of those questions, we're going to have to use this thing called a quadratic formula. Okay, so that's where we're heading. Let's get started. Let's start by finding the y-intercept of this graph, which we always just find by replacing x with 0. If we do that, we get f of 0 equals negative 3, which means we have a y-intercept of 0, negative 3. And we'll start by graphing that point right there. Well, how about x-intercepts? Well, to find x-intercepts, we replace y with 0, or we replace the function value with 0, and we solve for x. In this specific example, we can factor the right-hand side using whatever method you like. That is how to factor that appropriately. You can split this up into two different problems, and we get two x-intercepts. We get negative 1 half 0, and we get 3 0. Okay, well, things seem to be moving along pretty well. One more thing we might want to know about for this quadratic function is, where is its vertex? And a trick that we can borrow from calculus is that the x value of a vertex of a quadratic function in this form is always negative b over 2a. And in this example, that means negative negative 5 over 2 times 2. The negative negative becomes a positive, and we get that the x value of our vertex is 5/4. Well, x equals 5/4, that's like a little bit bigger than 1, so that's going to be somewhere along this line right here. But how do we find what the y value is for this vertex? Well, what we have to do is we just have to plug this x value into the function to figure out what y is. Unfortunately, that means dealing with some fractions. The notation for this is f of 5/4. If we square this fraction and then multiply it by 2, we end up getting 50 over 16. If we multiply 5 by 5/4, we get 25/4. We leave the minus 3 here. Now if we find a common denominator and add these three things together, we get negative 98 over 16, which actually does reduce, but it's approximately negative 6.125. So somewhere down here is our vertex, and it's 5/4. Negative, let's see, 98/16 reduces to 49/8, which is a little bit less than negative 6. Okay, great. So we can actually see what our parabola is basically going to look like. Beautiful drawing. And we're pretty happy with this problem. If we have a quadratic of the form ax squared plus bx plus c, we can find the y-intercept really easily by plugging in x equals 0. We can find the x-intercepts by plugging in y equals 0. And we can find the vertex by using this trick, negative b over 2a. It gives us the x value of our vertex. So that's almost always going to work. The problem is this step right here. In this problem that I made up, we were able to factor this right-hand side, but that's not always going to be the case. What if we can't factor this quadratic on the right side of the equation to find our zeros? We want to answer that question because it's actually really easy to come up with a quadratic that doesn't factor. For example, 2x squared plus 3x plus 4 equals 0. If we want to solve that for x, factoring just isn't going to work. So we have this thing called the quadratic formula that allows us to solve equations of the form 0 equals ax squared plus bx plus c. The solution is given to us in this somewhat complicated looking formula. Let's use this quadratic formula to solve for x in this equation right here. The first thing you'll want to notice is that our a value is 2, our b value is 3, and our c value is 4. Now we just have to substitute a equals 2, b equals 3, and c equals 4 into the quadratic formula and do our order of operations properly. That's going to look like this. I like to keep my values that I'm substituting into formulas in parentheses just to make sure I don't mess anything up. If we do our order of operations, that means we have to simplify the stuff under the square root first. Well, this is giving us 9 minus 32 under the square root. It's giving us a negative value under our square root, which we know from previous experience is not a real number, so for now we're just going to say no real solution. If we had a function 2x squared plus 3x plus 4, this operation would be finding that function's zeros, and we would have just discovered that this function has no zeros. It doesn't cross the x-axis. Okay, so let me alter the problem so that we'll get an answer that's just a little bit more satisfying. What if we want to find the zeros of 2x squared plus 3x minus 4? Well, what we do is replace the function with 0. We might try to factor this right-hand side, but we can't. So we have to use the quadratic formula. And we're going to use this quadratic formula with a equals 2, b equals 3, and c equals negative 4 this time. I'll make the substitutions. I'm going to simplify what's under the square root. You'll notice we get 9 minus a negative 32. That gives us 9 plus 32, which is now a positive number under our square root. And we have two zeros, negative 3 plus the square root of 41 over 4, and negative 3 minus the square root of 41 over 4. If we plug these into our calculator, we get approximately 0.85 as one answer, and approximately negative 2.35 as our other answer. If we wanted to make a little graph of this, 0.85 is a little bit less than 1. Negative 2.35 is in between negative 2 and negative 3. Finding a y-intercept is usually very easy, so I'll plug in x equals 0, and we get f of 0 equals negative 4, so we have a point down here at 0, negative 4. And a basic sketch of our parabola will look something like this. If you're curious as to what this vertex is, figure it out. Use the formula x equals negative b over 2a to find the x value, then plug that x value into the function to find the y value. Okay, obviously we'll work more with quadratic functions in the next class and also in the next video, so I'll see you there.